Every child that walks these halls has a story, takes a journey. This journey will affect them for the rest of their lives, and they all wish that it never happened. But this journey also involves so many people, people sent by God that they never wanted to meet, a club they never wanted to join. This is the story of my brother, his journey, his fight with cancer.
So, here we go. We're starting this journey, right? Well, we had a journey last week.
Yeah.
Yeah. What did we find out last week?
I have cancer.
Yeah.
In my leg.
Yeah. So, where are we going tomorrow?
Back to the hospital.
He was finishing up soccer, starting track practice, and was 2 weeks into baseball. And we thought he had a pulled calf muscle. I mean, I had no idea.
It's like breaking a leg, except for extra long.
While we were waiting for the results from all the scans, we told Jake this pain might be caused by cancer. And he had two immediate questions. He said, am I going to be able to play sports? And am I going to lose my hair?
That really stinks. I love my hair.
Can be.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the Tim Tebow, like the bowl cut, or whatever they call it. And then I'm gonna shave two sides off and get a mohawk.
Oh my.
And then shave that back again, like really thin, and then pull it all the way up and get the alfalfa.
He told a friend of ours that his mom and dad and the doctor said that he was gonna be okay, so from then on he didn't spend too much time worrying.
Well, I'm not really scared because I know that it can be treatable. It's treatable. So I know that it's gonna be okay, so. This is going to be awesome. People down there get to play a lot of video games. That always makes me feel better.
It was so strange to see Jake lying on the couch. It was totally weird to think that anybody like Jake could get cancer.
I could barely lift my eyes off the ground the morning that we walked into Shan's for his first chemo. It was one of the longest, hardest days of the whole thing.
So our new friends, the Blakemores, came to sit with us that first night. They had just finished up their chemo with their son. Jake honestly reminded me of Barb when she was pregnant, because he had a different craving every night in the middle of the night. Midnight rib run. Better than McDonald's. It was last week. Chili's. The half a rack.
Yes.
Go wash your hands. Go wash your hands.
Let me see it. Let me see it.
How's that?
Yes. I'm about to shave my head.
Why?
Because it's coming out, you see?
Yeah.
What happened to all that sand?
Whoa, oh,
I didn't think they would know.
Oh, man. Is it coming out?
Yeah. It's not okay.
He's going to lose his hair.
Oh, my God. I can't believe I just did that.
Here's the hair, everybody.
Alright, ready?
What are you doing?
Well, okay, you want to leave it?
Just cut my hair off.
Go over here.
I can't want to cut like a piece off.
I have no hair.
You look cute.
Isn't that weird?
Let's go write a song about hair.
I have no hair.
Either.
No.
Try this right here.
Can Cassie try?
Just go gentle. Look at Cassie. Cassie wants to do everybody's hair.
Crazy picture.
Crazy.
Thank you.
throat. Did you have to get that on film?
I want to see him now. And then I'm going to say kapow. That's nasty.
So we fell into a routine. Jake would roll out of bed at the crack of dawn. We would pack everything up and throw him in there while he was still half asleep. And Barb would usually do the first half of the week, and then I would come relieve her and stay the second half of the week and bring him home.
He really struggled with that 5-day treatment. We had to just try and be creative and find anything that might help the time go by, but it was just hard.
Oh, God.
Is it better?
No.
Dr. Gibbs was very clear with us. He said he would do all he could to spare the nerve, but his first priority was to get the cancer out.
We knew how blessed we were that the cancer was in his fibula, since that was a bone he didn't really need. But we just prayed that Dr. Gibbs could spare that nerve.
Day after surgery was really bad. My leg hurt a lot.
Oh, daddy.
Heavy. Yeah, it is. You got all that dressing on there, and then that block makes your muscles not work as good, so it makes it feel heavier. Very good.
Foot on the footstool. Okay, now push yourself back.
Switch back to your chair.
Switch back to your leg.
Yeah.
Push.
Push.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
You can use that
as
a table
if you want. I'm just like,
just stupid.
Okay, show me. Wow, Jake, that's so great. Can you pull your big toe back? I mean, it seems like you can. And are you sure it's still numb?
I don't really know.
Okay.
I don't really know, Mom. That's a good question.
After surgery, everything was different because we knew that the chemo had worked, and they told us that it had killed at least 95% of the cancer. Plus, we knew it was gone, it was out of them, so that we just breathed a sigh of relief.
Same time, we knew we had a million miles left to go, it felt like.
It's a big garage sale to help us, I guess, go from Gainesville. Shaved his head, his whole head. Not like a little bit, but shaved it.
We've been very touched by Jake's story. We've known his sister Cassie for years. And when we heard about what the Crumb Packer family was facing, we wanted to find a way to help.
I have a child, and I know that Barbara and Jan would be right there helping us if we needed it.
Snow, I forgot the colors that the grass tend to grow.
Jake to have hair.
What happens on Friday?
After Friday, he has hair.
Michelle, can I get your picture?
Oh my gosh.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm smiling.
Since we had to do it twice.
I could feel it completely the second time.
Alright, you ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Don't move.
Seriously?
Sorry.
Does that hurt?
No, no, what? But it's always like that.
It's just... Always, is it just like, the pressure of it?
Yeah, I don't feel the pressure.
No!
That is the worst part, the worst part.
It's okay.
It's all right, people. Which means you, Mom.
It's you're the only person in here.
Wee.
Can you go get me some milk, please?
Yes.
On his first trip to the hospital, Jake asked about the painted tiles on the ceiling. My parents told him that each tile represents a different child's journey. After each treatment, Jake was rolled out of the hospital in a wheelchair. After his ninth treatment, he said he wanted to walk. He said that he walked into this place, and he was dang sure he was walking out. This is the story of my brother Jake. His journey. His fight with cancer.
You're done, dude.
Yes, I am. Oh, God. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, yeah. Cause it will get hard. Remember, life's like a jump right up. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, yeah. It will get hard. Cause it will get hard.
There'll be a bump and there will be a bruise. There'll be alarms and there will be a snooze. There'll be a path that you will have to choose. There'll be a win and there will be a losing. You gotta hold your head up high and watch all the negative. I got-